Do you ever have those moments in the airport where you see somebody moving slower than you? Kind of painfully, even. They're doing the Tim Conway shuffle, you know. I have the greatest temptation to go up and ask them how old they are, because I want to know how many years I have left, you know. But I don't do that, because soon enough, somebody's going to be fighting off the temptation to come up and ask me, so. I have been thinking about some of the effects of aging. I see the most obvious one every time I look in the mirror, you know, to comb my hair and find none there. But I've been wondering about liver spots lately. Why are they called liver spots? Is it because they resemble the shape of a liver? Is it because they're the color of a liver? Or has someone actually tasted one of them? And I was also thinking, if we could put a positive spin on varicose veins, you know, there'd be like teenage girls painting thin lines on their legs, you know? Age hits you in different ways. I really don't think of myself as moving into the era of senility yet. But there are certain gaps in my... I did a benefit last night at a church where I had sung about 2 years ago. And after finishing the sound check, I realized that I had to go to the bathroom and that I'd really been putting it off for quite a while. Fortunately, I remembered that the parsonage was right next door to the church. What I didn't remember was that the parsonage was behind the church, and instead let myself into the back door of a house next to the church. Well, the door was open, you know. I knew we were going to have dinner, and there was this wonderful smell in the kitchen. And fortunately, the bathroom was just off the back stairs. So I let myself in, and as males do occasionally, I opted to stand. And the door opened, you know, behind me. And of course, I, wanting to make sure that somebody knew I was in here, said, "It's okay, it's me." I don't know what the guy must have been thinking, you know, because he closed the door. So I come out of the bathroom, you know, wondering where the dining room table is and we're going to eat at. And he comes walking towards me and I say, "Hi." And he says, "Hi." So, smells pretty good. We're eating, huh? I had so much energy, he was absolutely dumbfounded, right? Except that he kind of glanced nervously out into the room that I couldn't see where the rest of the family was sitting, and he said, "Uh-huh." And then he says something that kind of piques my curiosity. He says, "Are you singing next door?" I said, "Yeah," you know, figuring that maybe he just wasn't quite aware who was on the bill because there were a lot of us there. And then he said, "Are there any tickets available?" And I went, "Oh, you mean this is not the Parish House?" And he went, So I did the only thing that a freako from the 60s could do. I hugged him. I don't know, in these days of sexual harassment, there's no telling what that might be viewed as. You can imagine it from his point of view. You know, he's sitting down eating dinner and he hears the door open, right? He gets up from his chair just in time to see the bathroom door close. When he tries to open it, a voice says, "It's okay, it's only me." I can see him now. "Yeah, I think it's a burglar, Martha, but we'll wait. We got time."